And we are both a part of our senior design team. Our name is Hemo-Box, and we are designing a blood storage and transportation cooler.
We use coolers to transport blood throughout the hospital, mostly to the OR and then up to the patient's floor once they're done with their surgery. And right now we're just making coolers in-house, you know, just a commercial off-the-shelf cooler that we use cardboard and duct tape or wire baskets to keep the coolants from touching the blood. And it's very low tech. And we saw an advertisement in the university's daily email for requests for projects. And so we contacted the students and told them our requirements and had them design us something.
The standard cooler that you get at Target is what we're designing our device around. So our device fits into one of these normal coolers and just provides an extra layer of protection with temperature and recording the temperature and alerting if the temperature becomes unsafe for the blood products.
We've met periodically over the 2-semester course and we've talked about our needs. We took a visit down to the OR, we took a visit to the inpatient floors, so they just got a good idea of, you know, what we need them for.
It's been nice to be able to work so close with the customer. I know, for instance, I email our customer at least twice a week, all constantly like, oh, can you help me with this? And it's been great to have that nice customer designing relationship.
I think it's a little bit different when you're working on a project like this with a group of students without a lot of financial resources, and you're kind of messing around with the materials you buy at Home Depot. When you kind of try to think of ways to scale it up to a full industrial size manufacturing.
Starting to see a change in regulations to where they want a tighter temperature range monitored. And there has to be something better than cardboard and duct tape and wire baskets.
Well, I worked on the insulation, and we tried to coat it in something that was waterproof. And I tried fiberglass resin, which actually melted the insulation all the way through. So we had to go back to the drawing board on that one and refigure out what we were doing.
What it does is we put this cooler, the insert into the cooler. We kept with this because the cooler has good durable properties. The handles can't come off. They're pretty well made. We can't make a, you know, Rubbermaid's been making coolers for a long time. So you put the insert in, it has coolant packs and it can fit 10 blood bags.
Yeah, I would say it's relatively universal, but pretty much every single design that we've had has had problems, but I mean, that's how you get through it. Like other manufacturers, they make thousands of prototypes before they get their final product.
And then this will be attached, but the lid that's attached covers the products. On top there'll be a patient label. This is because the coolers are patient specific, and it will be under this the lid of the Rubbermaid cooler in order to prevent any discrepancies with HIPAA, because you need to keep patient privacy.
This is a great product that can be taken to market almost immediately after design. I think we definitely need to re-engineer some of the parts of the box so that they can be manufactured on a mass scale, but it's definitely a product that can be used. There's a definite customer for it.
We were pleasantly surprised. They did a really good job. We really like what they've designed, what we've seen so far. They've met all of our needs, and they've done a really good job.
A production of the University of Rochester. Please visit us online and subscribe to our channel for more videos.